We've all been there. Your line tightens, pulse quickens, and you set the hook fiercely into a solid, unmoving object. A snag can infuriate even the calmest angler. I've seen rods snapped in fits of anger and watched friends humiliate themselves splashing and flailing with Elaine Benis-style dance moves like a full-body dry heave, only angrier. It's as painful to watch as it is entertaining. A tantrum never yields positive results and usually ends in the re-rigging penalty box.
Who's dancing?
The next time you find yourself stuck, start by answering the following three questions. 1. What am I snagged on? I'll take a rock of any size over a log or piece of wood. It's usually easier to win against a rock because the hook liner weight is wedged and not buried. A sharp hook, especially when barbed, can embed in wood, digging deeper when yanked or pulled by current. And aquatic vegetation is usually a good thing to hang up on because fishing line is generally stronger than weeds and therefore can be pulled free. So if you feel a little stiff movement, it's probably wood. If you feel a lot of pliable movement, it's likely weeds. If it's stuck fast, it might be a rock. The second thing to ask yourself is what line you're using. Different lines have different properties. Braided line, for example, is thinner than monofilament, has less stretch, less abrasion resistance, and doesn't hold knots as well. It can also cast farther than monofilament and fly line, often making snags inaccessible due to their distance from the angler. Fly lines, on the other hand, are weighted and tapered, with the majority of the weight in the first 35 feet of the line. This weight can work for or against an angler when dealing with snags. We'll talk more about this later. Lastly, where am I snagged? A snag's location is probably the most significant factor when deciding if it's salvageable or cause for the point and pull. But what it really comes down to is this. No matter the water, line type, or object snagged, there are two basic elements of freeing a hook. Change angles and introduce slack. If that doesn't work, the hook point has likely entered the object. A hook point that is poked into something can only be removed by applying pressure in the opposite direction it entered. Here are some specific strategies I use to accomplish that. The roll cast. Walk slowly towards the snag while lifting the rod tip. Continue to step closer, raising the rod until it points almost straight up or about 1 o'clock on the clock. From there, raise your arms and rod tip high in the air before roll casting the line directly at the snag. This extra momentum transfers energy down the line until it hits the fly, jolting it backward and sometimes freeing it. The bow and arrow. This trick is most effective with braided line because it has very little stretch, but it can work for fly line or even monofilament, though it's far less effective. With this method, you twang the line like a bowstring. To accomplish this, you first need to get the rod out of the way. I tuck it under my armpit, but I've seen other people pinch it between their knees or set it down on the bank or in the boat. Once the rod is clear, pull the line tight to the snag with one hand. With your other hand, pick or twang the taut line and then release it completely. This sends a wave of energy down the line, kicking the lure backward and, if you're lucky, setting it free. The yo-yo. This is for those times when you get a bit overzealous trying to cast under an overhanging tree. Your line loops over a branch and your lure sways above the water like a pendulum. Don't rip it back. That often winds the lure around the branch multiple times, making it nearly impossible to retrieve. Instead, slowly draw the lure up until it's just under the obstruction and give it one short, swift pull. More often than not, your lure will hurdle the branch and drop almost where you wanted to cast it in the first place. Be sure to check the hook after every successful retrieval to make sure it's not bent out or damaged. Also, test your line for nicks or abrasions. Snags are part of fishing, but like most challenges in the outdoors, they are best addressed with a calm mind and knowledge of tactics to resolve the situation. Oftentimes, though, you simply need to know when to admit defeat and break the line. When you do, try to remember the maxim, if you're not losing gear, you're not fishing hard enough.